Hi there, this is a video in response to a tutorial video that was on YouTube talking about Steve Harris's style and Run to the Hills and how to play it faster. And the advice that they gave was crank up the volume really high, punch up the mids, and then play the strings very lightly with these two fingers and just keep up in the tempo. Now, kind of practicing against a click track and up in the tempo is not bad advice, but the advice on this Gallop and how Steve Harris plays is completely, in my opinion, kind of wrong. This isn't to badmouth that, it's to kind of help people who are trying to learn this style. If they stumble across that video and then they kind of go off on that direction, I believe it's the wrong way to do it. The Gallop that Steve Harris employs is very heavy on the strings. He uses both hands very carefully. So he does a lot of muting on the left hand, he does a lot of muting on the right hand as well. But it's done very, very much with these three fingers, is how I found I can play it. Now, the key thing as well is that you've got to remember everybody's a little bit different, so you can't just try and copy everything meticulously that he does, because he'll have different style, different size of hands, different dexterities. So the trick is how you get comfortable with the style so that you can play it and the songs as well. I learned the songs as a kid with headphones on with a Hondo 2 precision copy, which had action up here. So it built the calluses, it built the hand strength, and that's how I did it. So kind of without further ado, I'll go straight into it. And I'll show a couple of songs examples. I am very rusty, so I'm just doing this because I had to put my money where my mouth was. So hopefully you'll find it useful. So I'm gonna first do it without being plugged in or switched on. I've got Sandberg J bass here. This is a California. I use this because the tone is, there's a lot more variety in the tone. It's got active circuitry as well, which all helps. But the focus, firstly, well, I'm gonna turn the sound off so you can hear it, and then you can tune your own sound. But I'm also going through an Ampeg VA210 there, for those of you that you're interested. I'm gonna try and keep it basic. So firstly, without the amp and without it plugged in. So attacking the strings is really key to this. So I kind of put my hand over here towards the rear pickup. If you've got a P bass, then you're obviously, your two pickups will be roughly here. So it's just behind. That is how I feel comfortable. My right hand is very loose. It's very, very relaxed. I play with these three fingers, yeah? And as I said in my comments, the two fingers, the middle finger and the ring finger, usually play together, and it's like kind of a support hand. And my left hand, as much as I can, if you watch Steve Harris's videos, he often plays like this when he's playing a rhythm. And he kind of, he does mute the notes when it's needed in some of the songs that he plays. So just to give you a kind of without the amp on, a bit of sound, and we'll do Run to the Hills because that's what we're talking about here. So what was described was kind of playing out here with these two fingers and sometimes sticking this finger out to relax it. Now, by nature, that puts tension in your arm, I find. So the key is relax your hand, use your thumb to guide you up and down, and attack the strings. So I'm overdoing it a little bit there. But if I was doing Run to the Hills, so you can see there's nothing about those two strings. I'm using my whole hand actually, mostly those three fingers. And I'm really hitting the strings hard, but I'm controlling it with my left hand and my right hand. If you hear this, and there's a lot of timing involved in that as well. So that's kind of how I do it, attack it very hard. And I kill it with both the left hand and the right hand as I'm playing it. And the trick with this is play the slower songs, learn his style, learn the techniques he does. He does little kind of quippy things when he plays, but don't spend too much time learning every single phrase that he does. Learn the style and learn the method. You know, obviously the key phrases that you have to learn inside out are important for the song, but when there's stuff where you're just playing along with it, get comfortable with it and start utilizing these styles. And I'll talk about a little bit more about what I mean by that in a minute. But here, that's Run to the Hills. So let's crank up the sound. So you'll be able to hear straight away the strings bouncing off the neck and off the pickups here. So I'm going to do Run to the Hills here. So I haven't learnt it, but okay, so. Told you I hadn't learnt it. But there you can get the gist of it. So you've got to practice that. Now, the problem with Run to the Hills, as was quite rightly said in the video by Mark, is the you can't just do it that fast straight away, so you've got to practice it and practice it. And a good way to do that is with a click track or a backing track. But when you get that dexterity, that, to be honest with you, that it's the problem isn't the speed, it's how long you have to keep the speed up. Now, that's pretty horrendous. And the only way you can do that is by practicing it and playing it over and over and over again. So, I mean, if we speed it up a little bit, so that's the speed we were playing before. If you do this right and you get the technique right, you can do it incredibly fast. So, you see, you can do that there, and there's a bit in the middle, if I can remember it is. Oh yeah, so there's that bit in the middle where you've got Bruce screaming. I'll probably screw this up completely, so just bear with me, but you'll get the gist with the hand technique. So it's, So you can see whatever style he does, it's all hitting it hard. It's really clanging the strings. It's really working them hard. So you can hear that similar kind of gallop in Trooper as well. I haven't played this in ages, but I'll give it a shot. So, one's an example. I think it actually might go up an octave or down an octave or something in there. But what you can see there is that muting style kind of taking effect in the Trooper. Now that's another nightmare to play all the way through. Thank God it's only a short song. But these are all sort of things that he does. You know, another nice one is Rime the Ancient Mariner, which has got some lovely play bits in it. Now he, I think he plays some of those runs up here. I tend to play them here because it fits my hand a bit better. So, I always play it too fast, but it's actually quite slow. So, so that's so you can see that stuff that he does. I mean, this is one of my favourite bass lines. I haven't played it in ages, but there's those lovely bits in the middle where it goes. Something like that, anyway, yeah. There we go, that's it. So he goes, there goes the mariner, there goes the da-da-da. Anyway, other bits that you see him do quite often is this where he rolls or pivots off a note above, or below, sorry. So middle of Rime the Ancient Mariner is a really good one where he's got this sequence in the middle. which is always lovely to play. So, so really nice piece there, lovely to play. If you can remember 13 minutes of song, it's a good one to do. What other ones are there? There's a style that he does where it's kind of like a sweep. He uses that in Infinite Dreams, if I can remember that as well. Actually, that's not the bit I was talking about. I think it's the beginning bit, right? Anyway, so that's the style. You can see it's all fully hammered on. Left hand, a lot of muting, a lot of stuff going on there. Just threw in a couple of things that might be helpful to the style that you're trying to learn. As I said in my message, it's all about being full on. It's all about handling the guitar, controlling the guitar, but it comes with time. This cranking up the volume and trying to cheat it is not the right way to do it. You've got to get fully in there. As again, I'll get closer with this, so you can see the style on there. So if I do the gallop again, so it's, I'll do it very slowly. So. So if we're doing Run to the Hills. So it's dum, ba, 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 ba. You see how relaxed that is? But I'm hitting it hard. So if I speed it up, so I start slow. And I'll slowly speed it up, so it's. So you can hear that muting. So if I show my right hand, so my left hand, sorry. speed it up, you'll see that that timing's really important. Yeah, if I'll speed it up again, I'll go very close so you can see this. I don't know what the best angle is. So I'm going to start. So then speed it up. Do it even faster. Anyway, there you go. Hope you find that useful. You noticed then, actually, I noticed for the first time, that when I got faster, I actually played harder, not softer. So yeah, keen to hear your thoughts. Listen, I made a comment on there, kudos to people doing these tutorial lessons and putting the time in for it, but sometimes you've got to pipe up if it's completely wrong. I thought it was, that's my style that I've shown you, and that's how I do it. I hope it's been useful for anybody who's trying to learn those Maiden songs. Drop me a message or anything like that if you want me to kind of go into any more of the songs in a bit more depth. It'll probably encourage me to start playing my bass a little bit more, actually, which I haven't been doing so much lately. So sorry about how rusty it was. I hadn't learned the songs, but I wanted to get a quick response out there so that you could hear the style played properly. Hope it's useful. Hope it encourages you to learn more Maiden songs. They're touring this year in Europe. I'm going to go and see them. I'm going to love it. And I hope that you get a chance to see him live if you haven't already either. So take care, speak to you soon, bye.